Welcome to Switch Comics. My name is Marco.
I'm Chris.
Today we got a nice little haul for you. Mainly comics. We got a couple action figure and an action figure thing and a Funko Pop.
Yeah.
Before we get into it, as you all know, we are giving away some awesome comics at 800 subscribers. So,
close.
Just make sure you're following us, and whenever we get there, we will be giving away some cool things. That's a facsimile. All right. That was the Dragonzord. anyway, so I guess we'll start with the one and only Funko Pop we have. I picked up Tanjiro, the Box Lunch exclusive one that is glow-in-the-dark. I need to test this thing out. I haven't tried it, actually. But yeah, I started watching Demon Slayer, and now I have two Demon Slayer Pops. I have the Nezuko regular one, and then this one. I want the... I think it's a Box Lunch. It might be a Hot Topic. I don't remember, but the... Inosuke exclusive on that one, I think. And there's a good picture on it on the side there. But that one's pretty cool. Like that one a lot. Chris picked up
Lady J.
Lady J here. So, what is this, your second or third classified?
Third, technically, because we had Snake Eyes forever ago, and I don't know where he went.
Okay. And then one other figure, one we've been wanting for a while. Very excited to finally get our hands on Echo. The Target exclusive Black Series Echo. I hate that they made these Target exclusives.
Which is why we haven't had one.
Yeah, it was also very expensive. But this thing is super sick. I'm happy they finally made some Clone Wars figures. I'm just not happy at all the way that they decided to release them.
That's how they do.
Maybe in, I don't know, in the next coming weeks we'll be doing a... figure stream in case anybody's interested.
It'll probably be like half figures, half Legos.
I don't know. We'll see how long it takes. Yeah. We'll have some time to kind of, actually mess around with it a little bit more. Because I stopped opening figures during these videos because I just didn't feel like I had enough time to fully talk about everything. But the other figure-like thing we got was this cool Dragon Stars martial arts arena, which I hate Dragon Stars. I think they make terrible figures, but what a sweet little prop that they made. Which we do have, three? We have three Figuarts figures.
Four, technically.
Do we? We have Broly, Trunks, Vegeta, and what else?
Big Vegeta.
The Great Ape Vegeta. I wasn't thinking of that.
That's why I said
Yeah, okay. You're right. I guess he could be behind it and might be a little fun, but
there doesn't even have to be Dragon Ball figures. Just put any kind.
True, I guess it is just a nice little tournament. You could, for fun, whoever you want to fight versus each other. Now, we haven't opened this yet. Again, we'll save it for the stream. But I'm hoping it does look pretty cool, and I love any time that they do, accessory and set pieces and stuff like that. Because if you were to, try... Because this thing was, $35. That was it.
G.I. Joe's good about that.
$35 for this giant thing.
This
That's
Lady
awesome.
J one. There's literally just two spears.
Yeah, you and now, is that going to be the best, most high-quality martial arts tournament setup in the world? No. But it is good enough, and $35. You know what I mean? So, that is it for figures, pops, and... Well, that's it. Figures and pops. Okay, I'm going to let you sit those over there, because then we're going to get into some comics. Starting off with, we had a sale recently at a shop where we had a bunch of comics for only 50 cents. So we went through and found some cool stuff that we liked. So starting off here with a cool New Mutants cover. I like my magic covers, and that one is pretty fun. Not one of my favorites, but definitely worth a pickup for 50 cents. Then we picked up Nova. Which is, this is, not his first series. Obviously, that's his first series. But just one that, I thought it was fun. It's still, number one. But then I picked up some cool X-Force covers. And I think they all have X-23 on them. This one's pretty cool. This one's my favorite right here. I like this one a lot.
Yeah, that's a nice group shot.
Yeah, it's just a really sweet cover. And then, so you got some good X-23 goodness on there. I like me my X-23. Where's she at? Yeah, there she is. And then we have this sweet kitty picture here. It's a comic, not just a picture, but nice cover. Got Lockheed on it as well. That one is looking pretty sweet. I think we might already have had this comic, but whatever. We picked it up again, or maybe for the first time. Who knows? Yeah. But
we love Trigun.
Yeah, Trigun is an amazing old school anime. Why is it falling forward like that? Anyway, so yeah, definitely had to make sure to pick that one up. Here is, this is an homage to an older book. I can't remember. I think, right?
Yes.
Yeah, there's an older one that has them coming at each other like that. Anyway, I'm a big Iron Man guy, and he's a big Doctor Doom guy. So, you know, it's a good comic for the both of us. Again, here's another one.
I'm in the same pose. He's always ready to punch Iron Man.
I don't even remember picking that one up, but there it is. We've had these, like I said, that sale was a few weeks ago, so I don't even remember a lot of these.
This one, Doom's finally another one here. Learned to use a weapon.
Yeah. You don't see him with a sword too often.
Usually the gun.
And then this is one I've kind of wanted for a little while now, but anyway, you know, again, found in 50 Cent Bin, so Kitty Pryde and Wolverine. Just one that I've always thought was pretty fun. And then, oh yeah, The Warriors 3. That was a fun little find. I didn't even know this existed until I saw it. I was like, oh, well, neat, whatever. And then we got a Dark Horse Presents here with an alien. There's a lot of cool Dark Horse Presents stuff with aliens and predators on it. And I thought this was a pretty sweet cover. I like it a lot. I really like... I like the decision to make the corridors green so that it helps. Because even though it's all still pretty dark, it's just enough, you know, it's green as the highlight, and then they have the blue as the highlight. So it helps to differentiate them. Yeah. Kind of gives them almost like a video game kind of look almost. But then we have Magic number 2 here, which I have about number 1 a while back. And again, big Magic fan, so I will definitely always keep grabbing those. Sweet Man-Thing cover, which I don't care about the Thing, but I do like Man-Thing. So I had to grab that one.
There's a man. There's a Thing.
And then I grabbed, let's see, what are the issues numbers on these? So this is a series I didn't know was written by Jed McKay, but we found some, it's just Daredevil, Man Without Fear, right?
Yeah.
Anyway.
Daredevil,
just Man Without Fear. Oh, it's just Man Without Fear, isn't it? Oh, yeah, okay. Anyway, so yeah, it's but written by Jed McKay, so I found issues 3, 4, and 5, which are all pretty sweet covers. But yeah, also written by Jed McKay, which is a writer that I've come to fall in love with here recently. So, and I think it's just a 5-part miniseries, so I definitely need to go back and try to find the first 2 issues so I can read that one. And then another one that I didn't get to bagging, because I found it later than the other ones, was this fun Monsters cover, which is a kind of a weird book, because it just has, like, the insides of monsters and stuff. Which was, that's kind of fun, but again, mainly, it just had that big fun. I don't know. I mean, definitely it has Man-Thing on it. I like Man-Thing, so I got it for that reason. But also, I like the cool kind of classic vibe that it has going on with it. And then, other than that, I've been on a bit of a High Republic kick. I'm sure, you know, everyone's noticed that, you know, High Republic keys have been going up. And granted, pretty much almost every copy of High Republic or High Republic Adventures or this, that, or whatever, like almost all of them have first appearances in it. But now granted, there's key certain ones that do have first appearances. Well, and I didn't really remember. And that's the thing. There's so many first appearances in these books that I do not remember, you know, which ones or which, you know.
Definitely got like a story in there.
But I picked up... does it?
Yeah.
I just thought it was like just pictures. Anyway,
no.
So I picked up just a few issues here. I picked up a number 10, just some stuff I've been finding. This is a number 10 as well, but a variant with, what's her name, Lorna D. I don't think that's her first cover appearance. It might be. I can't remember. And that... because I don't... 10 might be her first appearance. And I picked up for a reason, and I can't remember. Like I said, I have to go to Key Collector whenever I'm looking at any High Republic books, because there's, like I said, there's just so many. This one was some kind of first appearance, but this is a 1 in 10. So I picked up actually 2 of those. I thought they were a pretty good price. And I've just, like I said, I've been noticing they've been going up in price. So I decided I would go ahead and pick it up. Now, these are pretty fun. I got Miss Marvel number 5 here, and I also got Miss Marvel number 6. And I don't know, I haven't told you about these, I don't think, Chris.
Nope.
Do you know anything about like Miss Marvel characters and stuff or whatever?
No.
So, you know, just trying to think like with these new upcoming projects, like there's obvious ones. Okay, we need to get first appearance of Miss Marvel. We need to get first appearance of what else is coming up? I don't know, whatever, you know, Moon Knight. You got these different shows. But yeah, She-Hulk and all these different things. But then you need to start thinking, like, okay, what are the side characters and villains and different little things that are going to pop up? And this one isn't one that I necessarily feel confident about. But when I heard the description of, and I don't really know a lot about Ms. Marvel, but again, I saw this in Key Collector. And so number 5 is the first cameo, and then number 6 is the first full appearance of a clone of Thomas Edison mixed with a cockatoo or a cockatiel. I think it was a cockatoo. Hmm. So I was like, that's fun.
Yeah.
Whether anything will come of that, I don't know. Now, granted,
I hope so.
That is, you know, that is part of the first run of her first solo run. So, and I don't really know exactly what they're going to be taking up from inspiration, but you know, they're relatively cheap keys, and I thought that could be a way to spice up the MCU, you know? So I was like, I think his name, the character's name is the Inventor. So yeah, I decided to pick those up because that sounded pretty fun. And then we picked up some Moon Knight 1 in 25. So this is Moon Knight 8, 1 in 25. A pretty good one.
Nice cover too.
It's a good one.
Not as good as the next,
but it doesn't, it doesn't compete with this one. The number 9.
It's so good.
This series has been loaded with all kinds of great covers, and this is one of the best ones.
Pretty goddamn beautiful.
Now this one also, didn't it have some kind of first appearance in this one as well?
What's his name?
Or cameo? I'm trying to remember now.
It was technically like a first appearance, but it's,
I don't remember.
It's something winter.
Winter? Or
winter?
Winter. Oh, that's right. It might be a cameo appearance. I don't know if I count it. I guess it's not really much of a spoiler. Because I'm not saying who it is or anything. I guess you kind of said his last name. But anyway. The very last page has a picture of this guy on a piece of newspaper. You know, in the comic, it's on it's a piece of newspaper.
They also tell you in the last book.
Does that count
that he broke out of prison?
Yeah, does that count as a cameo? I don't know.
I mean, he's also standing there next to the newspaper.
Oh.
You don't remember that?
No, I guess I was distracted by the newspaper.
Yeah, you were. You ding.
Huh. I'll have to go back and look at that. Anyway, there's one that eluded me for a while that I meant to get, that I should have got, rather, when it came out. And it hasn't gone up a lot, but it's been kind of climbing. It's kind of staying just a little bit higher than what I could have paid for it. Now, granted, this I priced
it. Rutherford. That was his name.
Yeah, I bought this one off eBay. I got an, what's it called? A auction. So I didn't pay this price tag, but they went ahead and sent it with the price tag on it. So, but Hulk 3, the 1 in 25, this beautiful Tradmore cover. I know some people don't like it. Tradmore is kind of a divisive artist anyway.
He's a divisive arsonist.
But I think this cover has a lot of energy to it. And then obviously it's the first cameo of Titan. And I'm kind of buying into it. You know, I'm excited. We'll see what happens with it. But I think it's a sweet cover and a nice key as well. So then this is another one that I picked up here recently. Kind of talking about nice little, you know, cheaper keys to get. Picked up America number 1. This is America Chavez's first solo series book. And a beautiful, beautiful cover. I like this cover a lot. And I bought it off eBay, and I think it is in beautiful condition. Like, I need to, I don't think
I have those exact glasses.
You know what? You might, actually. I didn't think about that. But I need to take it out of the bag and look at the back of it, because I haven't done that yet. But just looking at the front of it, like, this might be grade-worthy. It's a pretty nice copy. And then there's one book I forgot to grab out of here. I'll move that real
Which
quick.
Which one is it?
It is this last one. Oh, so, yeah. I did a trade. A buddy of mine that I knew was into Spider-Man books. Well, first of all, he messaged me, asked if I wanted a comic that he had. He just recently got graded and asked me if I'd be interested in it. I was like, maybe. And so I knew he was in Spider-Man books. So I was going through my stuff and I was looking at it. I was like, you know what? I have a copy of 238 and it's pretty rough. Don't get me wrong. It was in pretty rough condition. But that book is kind of known for being, like, it's not uncommon for it to be rough because of the tattoos. When you pull out the tattoos, which, again, fairly common. So mine was missing the tattoos. But when you pull out the tattoos, you can mess up the staples. There's just a lot that can go wrong with that book. And it's pretty well known that it's a book that the lower grades actually hold decent value just because of how common it is, if that makes sense. So yeah, even my beat up copy, you know, still had decent value to it. And like I said, I know this is a big Spider-Man fan. He literally gets, because, you know, he goes to the shop and I do his pull list. He gets everything Spider-Man or Spider-People. You know, if it's Spider-Girl or Spider-Woman or Spider-this or that, he's getting all the Gwenverse stuff, you know. Any Spider-anything, he's all about it. So I was like, you know what? I think he'd actually really like this book. And I asked him about it. And because the book he had was a West Coast Avengers 45. He just got graded back at a 7.0. You know, lower grade book. And so, anyway, I asked him if he'd be interested. And he said yes, but he didn't feel the trade was exactly fair on his end. And so without me asking for anything, he just went ahead and said, you know what? He sent me a picture. He's like, would you also want this? Which is the Thor number 1 in 50 art germ cover. Or, I'm sorry. This is the 1 in 200. This is the 1 in 200 art germ cover. Which, one, I'm a huge fan of art germ. Two, it's a surprisingly low-value book for it being a 1 in 200 and a 1 in 200 art germ. Now, granted, I think this book has a very high print run on it. I don't know the exact numbers, but I do think it has an extraordinarily high print run. That being said, this book has a lot of meaning to me because Thor issue number 1, first of all, it's just an incredible read, but kind of is the reason that I got into comics because the Thor run was kind of early on when I started working at the comic shop. Now, granted, you know, we also do pops and action figures and stuff. So when I started working there, I wasn't a comic guy. I was, you know, there for action figures mainly. And then, you know, I heard some good things about this Thor run and some, I don't know, it was probably a fourth print or whatever came out of number one. And I decided to pick it up and give it a shot. I like Thor, you know, so I was like, I'll give it a read. And I fell in love with that book. And then, you know, I went back and had to get all the whole series and everything. And still, I think this series is kicking it strong. And yeah, so that book means a lot to me in several regards because Thor 1 of Donny Cates' run, you know, got me into where I am now, where I have, you know, like 60 comics on my pull list. You know, it started all this. So, it even though it is shockingly low in value for a 1 in 200, I was baffled when I looked up, like, how much this thing actually goes for. It does have a lot of, I guess, sentimental value is the right word, even though it's like this particular copy doesn't bring back memories, but it's like, it's a cool version of the book that I really love. And, yeah, so that's, it for the haul.
Yeah.
But yeah, a good stack of comics, a few figures. Stock. And then, yeah, I think we're going to be playing another, session of Raft on this stream, but maybe possibly next week's stream, we might do a figure opening and messing around with the figures and stuff. Like I said, we'll have more time to really, explore everything and change out all the hands and accessories and all that type of fun stuff that we don't typically have time to do on the channel. So if you're interested in stuff like that, or you just want to, you know, talk about these comics or whatever.
Or you want to look at puppies.
Yeah, I don't want to pick up the other one. He's over here, but he is dead asleep.
Knocked out.
Completely knocked out. Like, I'm kind of pushing on him, and he's not budging at all.
He's eyes me a little bit. He's like, oh, what are you doing?
He's like, why are you pushing me? But tongue out and everything. But anyway. Thank you all so much for watching, and I guess we'll see you next time.
Bye.